Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about diffusion and how it has the power to increase the size of your room. Not physically, obviously. I had somebody ask me that the other day. But anyway, there's a psychoacoustic component to diffusion, and we'll talk a little bit about that. So diffusion is a technology that makes a small room sound larger. Now, how does it do that? That's the key, okay? So its function, it's to minimize the psychoacoustic impact of reflections. So our brains, when we have our room and we have a surface in the room and sound strikes that surface and comes back and enters our ears, there's a component in that distance that allows in our hearing system for us to kind of measure distance, how far away that object is. Some of us are better at it than others. But we all kind of have that ability. So reflections help us localize distance. So if we can control reflections, we can have an impact on the perception of distance, how far away things are. When I had my studio in Hollywood, our ceilings were 9 foot. We'd put blindfold people, bring them into the room, put them in the listening position, play a couple songs, ask them how far away the ceiling was. 12 foot, 13 foot, common guesses. It was actually 9, but it had quadratic diffusion on it. So you can see the impact of minimizing reflections with diffusion just in that little example. And it goes all the way through the process. What is diffusion? Quadratic is the only one that we use. It's the only one that's predictable and consistent. It's a series of wells or troughs that take larger reflections and break them into smaller ones. So if you take the surface area of a diffuser and you put energy into it, it comes out in a much smaller pattern than a big primary reflection. So it's a series of secondary, I guess you could say, reflections. So that also have to realize that it acts as a magnifying glass. So if you don't have all the issues in your room that diffusion requires that you have treated, then it's going to make them sound worse. So you must have reverb times balanced throughout the room and all your modes tamed. Or diffusion will make your room sound worse, especially with reverb times. So when we design rooms with diffusion in them, we always overabsorb a little bit, because we know we're adding diffusion, which is going to punch up the reverb time a little bit. So you put it in a room with high reverb times. We get this with churches all the time. Well, we want to use diffusion. No, you don't. Diffusion increases reverberation times. That's the last treatment you want to use. And you don't need to take a large room and make it sound larger, which is another function, psychoacoustic function of diffusion. You want to absorb that 125 to 500 hertz range with absorption technology. Not 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch, 4 inch deep panels, but more like 6 and sometimes 8 inch deep panels. We see a lot of failure in this area. I don't know where these companies get off selling large amounts of 1 and 2 inch. Well, I know why they do it, but it doesn't work because they don't get enough of that 125 to 500 cycle range, which is the most critical frequency range for reverb. Talk to some of them, they don't even know what that is. The people that sell the technology. Go figure that one, all right? So we get a wider sound stage. We get increased depth if we're talking about two-channel. Even theater, we've heard that too. There's more space between the notes and chords. There's quietness. There's more darkness, if you will. It's a weird term, I know, but those of you that have been listening to music for a long time understand that. Placement depends on usage. So two-channel, we like front and rear wall. Ceiling, sometimes, depending on the height of your speakers. And home theater, we like ceiling and rear wall. Those are the two that we do a lot of, and that seems to work out the best. People say, well, why don't you put diffusion on the sidewalls? The reason we don't use diffusion on the sidewalls is because sidewall reflections provide that center image focus, and diffusion will have an impact on that that we don't particularly like. Now, it's not something that's absolute. Everybody's a little bit different. Some theaters like it on the walls too, because they really want to open up the spatiality. But you sacrifice a little bit in center, image, definition, and separation. So in two-channel, that's very, very critical. Distance. Placement is very, very critical. It's distance-dependent because you got to have enough space requirement for the lowest frequency of your diffuser to fully form. So this is where quarter, half wavelength rules come into play. So you always want to try to get the largest prime number you can for quadratic diffusion for your usage and your space requirement and your budget, obviously. So you want to make sure you get the highest prime number sequence that you can with diffusion, but you want to make sure that you have enough distance between your ears and the diffusion surface area so that the lowest waveform, let's say a 17 is 250 hertz, somewhere around there. So you have to have enough distance for that waveform to fully form, 4 or 5 feet, somewhere in there. Okay, so that's why. Now we have two ways of getting it. We can build them for you, or you can build them yourself. We have the plans. You can go on the shop section and see that. Make sure you select the right diffuser for the right usage and the right distance. It's critical. And if you do, you'll get a room that sounds twice as big as your physical dimensions. Who doesn't want that? Everyone does. Diffusion, 2x increase. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. And if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to. So please do that, because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple of days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.